Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. This is Wednesday, May 27th already. It's 9:53 a.m. And I'm going to keep this short and to the point because I believe most of you probably know this, but I have some new subscribers and some people that may not understand or know about these people. Our sister Ellen sent this to me, and I mistakenly thought she was sharing it like she was for them, you know, like, oh, you got to watch this. So, you know, I was probably really tired when I watched this and thought that. But anyway, she wrote me back and said, I don't know why you thought I'd be for them. Okay, because I watched this a little bit and I knew right off, you know, it's called the Unveiling - Bill Johnson and Francis Chan. And I thought, didn't I do a video about Francis Chan and how I loved him and thought he was this great preacher? And then he started preaching something that sounded New World Order-ish, you know, like, let's all unite. And it talks about, who was it, Bill? I don't even want to play any of it. I'm just warning you. It's called, the channel is Popular Gospel. Now, I'll just tell you right here. Remember when I shared a video from Bill Johnson? I'm pretty sure that was him. Of that, what's the name of that church in California? I can't remember. Mike Bickle is another one. So it says, Francis Chan apologizes for speaking against men like Bill Johnson and Mike Bickle and explains his reasons for finding unity with charismatics that he once spoke against. And I had sent to Ellen, I said, unity equals New World Order. And it does. You need to be aware, okay? Some very godly Christians are being, you might call it bullied into believing that if we don't believe in unity, that we should all come together. We're not much of a Christian. You know, we think we're better than everybody. Or do you think you're something special? Are we not all God's children? Or however they word it. I say they got to Francis Chan with a bunch of money, but I don't know. You don't turn that easily from what you know is true to joining something like this New World Order, one world religion, unified with Catholicism, Muslims, Buddhists, and others. And they just show several faces on here. I don't know who these people are, but I've seen him. I'm not sure who this singer is. And it really grieved my heart to hear that Hillsong, and even who's the one I like so much, Misty Edwards, was in the worship team of, one of those churches that I'm speaking of. And I went back and listened to some of the songs that I had of hers, and I really, you know, I was like, not sure. I just deleted them. I'm like, you know, if this person is involved in the she's with the Bethel Church. Yeah, that was it. I'm pretty sure. And I thought her songs were unusual and very, like, intimate with the Lord. Like, you're just very close with Him. And so I had a hard time understanding how she could be involved in that. But if her spirit cannot see the problems there, then I just rather not listen to her anymore. So I just deleted everything I had of hers. So anyway, I just wanted to tell you all that, even if you don't choose to watch this. Again, the channel, if you listen to it, is Popular Gospel. The word popular, right there. Anything that is popular with the world is going to be anti-Christ. Because the truth is not popular. Let's face it. I think that's what I'm going to title this. The truth is just not popular. So, I think that's enough said. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth over myself, my computer, my internet connection, and this video, so it'll go up and stay up, because I want people to understand that unity, watch out for that word unity, that we must unify or we're not good Christians. We're not loving enough. Anyway, pray for extra discernment. If you hear a message about unity and you think there's nothing wrong with this message, you ask the Lord, okay? Take it to the Lord. I'm serious. Jesus did not say to any of the Pharisees and Sadducees and anybody that I'm here to love you, and as long as you believe in me, you're okay. Well, hey, this unity thing doesn't even say that. You don't even have to believe in Jesus, just God, and you'll go to heaven the same as the rest of us. No, you won't. You have to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, that He died and rose again 3 days later. You have to believe those things. You have to believe you need to repent, confess your sins, and pick up your cross and follow Him. We must obey His commandments to love the Lord our God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. And all of that is what you might call expounded on in the sermons of Jesus and then through Paul and Luke. Luke was a Gentile physician who knew so much about the Lord. Most likely he was around because he was a physician and just chose to work in that area helping people, you know. He knew about Mary and her birth. How did, you know, was it word of mouth? No, it was probably the Holy Spirit. And partly word of mouth, you know, because he being around the rest of them, he's going to hear what they had to tell him, you know, based on what Joseph told them. Joseph and Mary were the witnesses. And the shepherds, let's not forget them. Anyway, now I'm getting off on another tangent. So I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you and all of your devices and your internet connections. And I pray we get to stay together on this platform until we're out of here. I was checking out Brighteon because I'm kind of sick and tired of our videos being taken down just because we're telling the truth. There's no way for you to comment or share a video that I could find. Now, if somebody else could go to Brighteon.com, create an account. That was no problem. You put in your email address. You choose a password, just like, and you choose a username. Like, okay, beside your email, you can choose, like, I'm Jeannie H. If you ever see Jeannie H., commenting, or I guess there must be a way to comment. I had to choose a username, but yet on the video I watched, Plandemic, which I did see on YouTube and it got pulled, and I watched part one again to see if maybe I didn't finish it, and then I watched another one on vaccine damage, and oh, it was so good. I'll just go ahead and tell you all. This one video I watched, I couldn't even tell you the title of it. But when you look at it, it said cancer real big in the bottom. It was under videos about vaccines. And then you get a whole list. And then you get another page and another page. It was like page 7. Anyway. I'll try to find the title if anybody wants to know it, but it was agreeing with that doctor that was on with Yana that I shared, Yana Danoon on Israeli News Live, okay, has the picture of the woman and then Steve and Yana split. You know, it's like two pictures in one. That's the video a couple days ago, maybe 3 now. But this person was agreeing, saying the same thing. A doctor that Mikovits, how she had been fired, jailed, and I told you about her. I did share something about her. Okay, so she was in that video. I'm pretty sure, Lord, let me have my memory. Please, I need my memory. At any rate, it was about okay. Viruses didn't cause polio and a whole bunch of other stuff, and it was DDT, pesticides, and they had to come up with an excuse. Those were started in the 1800s, and people that started coming down with polio, they said it was all in their head, that they couldn't find any reason for it, and then finally they said, oh, this is caused by a virus. And then another doctor came up with some, you know, thing they jab in your arm or put on a sweet cube you could swallow. Called it a vaccine. Which I don't know if that's a code word, but you know, I'm so sick and tired of this. You got to watch what you say. Every word AI is going to pick up on, and then they're going to flag and look over every word you say. Anyway, I was looking into this to see about switching over to that. And there are a lot of great videos on there that have been taken down from YouTube. People put them up over there. So if you want to learn more about these subjects and the things we have to put on our, you know, hook around our ears, those things, you can get all kind of information over there. I'll just say that for now and bye for now. I'm going to go paint. I got on my paint shirt. This poor paint shirt. put it on to paint. Yesterday, I never did paint. It's like, oh, I just can't do it. But I'm determined to get that first coat on all the upholstery. I'm going to take a good look at it and decide if I'm going to tint it any different. Greener, yellower, not sure. It may be just exactly right. When I'm all done, I might decide, no, I like it just the way it is. Okay, so I will talk to you all later, and I'll be checking for comments and emails later on in the day. Okay, you all have a blessed day or night whenever you see this, and I will talk to you later. Bye for now.